There's nothing mysterious about lawn tennis. It's a game that can be enjoyed at any age. Do you agree, Lou?
I certainly would, Lord Aberdare, but I feel that the earlier you can start playing, the better. And, well, you go on to bigger and better things. But it's nice that you've brought these two young fellows along. How old are you, Alistair?
I'm 12, Mr. Hayne.
How long have you been playing tennis?
I've only just begun.
Well, that's good. How do you hold the racket on the forehand? Not quite, Alistair. Place your right hand on the strings of the racket and draw the hand down the side of the racket till you come to the grip and you shake hands with it. Now, this is what they call the Eastern forehand grip. Now, for the backhand, you turn the racket a quarter turn to the right, and there you have your backhand grip, which is also your service grip.
How about the forehand stroke itself?
Get the racket back. As soon as you see the ball is coming to your forehand, get your knees bent, keep your eye on the ball, and have your left foot way out in front. And it's exactly the same on the backhand, only you change your grip, of course. You have your right foot forward. It's the same stroke from the other side of the body. How about you, Jamie?
I'm left-handed, so it's different for me.
You're quite wrong there. Exactly the same rules apply if you're left-handed or right-handed. Let's try something different. How about a serve? On the serve, you should have, as I already explained to Alistair, the backhand grip, and you should be nice and comfortable when you're standing behind the baseline. Throw up the ball at least 2 to 2.5 feet in front of you in a straight line, not in an arc. Have a good long backswing. You don't actually hit the ball with your arm, but with the weight of your body, and that is where you get all your power from. Now the volley, Alistair. The volley is possibly the most important stroke in tennis today, and in the volley, on both the forehand and backhand, you use exactly the same grips as on the forehand drive and the backhand drive. The only difference is that you shorten your swing and you hit the ball more in front of you. It's more of a punch.
How does one learn all these things?
By watching good players. There's a practice game going on over here. Let's go and see what happens.
We should certainly learn something from this game. Neil Fraser of Australia is playing Barry McKay of America.
We certainly should. Neil Fraser is serving.
Fault?
Neil was just foot-faulted.
Why?
You see, both feet must be behind the baseline at the moment when the server strikes the ball. In this case, Neil's back foot swung over the line and is in court at the moment his racket struck the ball.
Net. Second service.
That ball just hit the top of the net before it fell into the correct service court. So it's a let, and Fraser is allowed another serve. Had the ball struck the top of the net and then fallen out of court, it would have been a double fault and he would have lost the point. Fraser's serving again. That's a nice shot. Straight down the line, giving Barry no chance at all.
Juice!
I thought it was out of court.
No, it was just in, Alistair. You see, it landed right on the line, which in tennis counts as in.
Fraser's serving again. Whose point would it be if he served from the wrong court?
Well, that's a good question, Jamie. If he serves from the wrong court and the mistake is not discovered until after the point is completed, the point stands and the next service is made from the same court.
But if he serves a fault when serving from the wrong court and then realizes his mistake, he's allowed only one more serve into the correct court. That's right, isn't it, Lou?
Quite right. But look at this exciting rally. Fraser is putting a drop shot into the right-hand corner. No, Barry anticipated very well, and he's up at the net to put it right back past Neil.
This is men's singles at its best, each player in turn trying to get the attack and get up to a dominating position at the net.
Vantage, McKay.
Can you stand as near the net as you like, Mr. Head?
Yes, but you must be careful not to strike the ball on your opponent's side of the net. It has to cross the net before you can hit it, Alistair.
What happens if you hit the net?
You lose the point, Jamie, whether you hit the net with your racket or whether any part of your body touches it.
Did you see that? Fraser threw the ball up to serve, then caught it again without hitting it. Is that a fault?
No, Alistair, it's not. He's allowed to do that as long as he doesn't take a swing at the ball.
Golly! Fraser's smash has hit McKay. Whose point is that?
That's a point to Fraser. Incidentally, Jamie, if the ball hits you on the full, whether you're standing inside the court or outside the court, you lose the point.
Juice!
Look, the ball has hit another loose ball lying on McKay's court. Is that a let?
No, Alistair, McKay loses the point. It's up to the player on whose side the ball is lying to clear it off the court before the point is played.
Advantage, Fraser.
A lucky one for Fraser. The ball just struck the top of the net, balanced for a moment, and fell over on the right side where McKay couldn't get it.
I thought it was a let when it touched the top of the net.
No, only on the service. In a rally, it counts as a good stroke.
Game, set, and match to Fraser.
Well, that's the end of the match. Let's go and talk to the players, Lou, and we can introduce the boys to Harry Hopman.